Good afternoon and welcome to St. Mary's on this 19th Sunday in Ordinary Time. We ask that you receive communion in your hand, but if you prefer to receive it on the tongue, please come forward at the end of the procession. Our presider is our pastor, Father Talbot. Please stand as you are able as we begin the celebration.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. Good evening, everyone. Welcome, welcome, welcome to those joining us via live stream. Ask you to please keep in your prayers Tom Manlett, who died this past week. His funeral is going to be on Tuesday. Jeanette Johnson, her funeral was last Friday. Connie Mueller, her funeral is going to be a week from Tuesday, and Andy Ritchie died earlier today. We're still waiting on news on that funeral. May their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. As we come together to celebrate these beautiful mysteries, this participation in this greatest act of faith, Jesus going to the cross in obedience to the Father for our salvation, we ask for mercy for those times we have sinned. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
We praise you, we bless you, we
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The night of the Passover was known beforehand to our fathers, that with sure knowledge of the oath in which they had put their faith, they might have courage. Your people awaited the salvation of the just and the destruction of their foes. For when you punished our adversaries, in this you glorified us whom you had summoned. For in secret, the holy children of the good were offering sacrifice and putting into effect with one accord the divine institution. The word of the Lord. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Brothers and sisters, faith is the realization of what is hoped for, and evidence of things not seen. Because of it, the ancients were well attested. By faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called out to go to a place that he was to receive as an inheritance. He went out, not knowing where he was to go. By faith, he sojourned in the promised land as in a foreign country, dwelling in tents with Isaac and Jacob, heirs of the same promise. For he was looking forward to the city with foundations, whose architect and maker was God. By faith, he received power to generate, even though he was past the normal age and Sarah herself was infertile. For he thought that the one who had made the promise was trustworthy. So it was that there came forth from one man, himself as good as dead, descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky and as countless as the sands on the seashore. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not be afraid any longer, little flock, for your Father is pleased to give you the kingdom. Sell your belongings and give alms. Provide money bags for yourselves that do not wear out, an inexhaustible treasure at heaven, that no thief can reach nor moth destroy. For where your treasure is, there also will your hearts be. Gird your loins and light your lamps, and be like servants who await their master's return from a wedding, ready to open immediately when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds vigilant on his arrival. Amen, I say to you, he will gird himself, have them recline at table, and proceed to wait on them. And should he come in the second or third watch and find them prepared in this way, blessed are those servants. Be sure of this: if the master of the house had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would not have let his house be broken into. You also must be prepared, for at an hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come." The Gospel of the Lord. Many people have asked me my favorite thing from the recent trip to Ireland. Well, we celebrated Mass at some great places, at the Shrine of Knock and at the Tomb of St. Patrick. We visited Belfast in Northern Ireland and learned of the Troubles. We kissed the Blarney Stone. We stood on the majestic cliffs of Moher and the Giant's Causeway. We toured the Titanic Museum, played around a round of golf at a very picturesque course in Donegal, lost a lot of golf balls. We stayed at a stunning castle, and we ventured into a pub or two to visit with the locals. My most memorable thing was not one of those. In fact, it was not a particular place or a specific event. Rather, my most memorable part of the trip was traveling through the countryside, seeing how the land changed from rich land for farming into rocky, not so good land for farming, and thinking events of more than 170 years ago, when 8 young people from Tipperary, Limerick, Cork, Louth, and Leitrim left that land and their families, got on ships, and made the dangerous journey to America. Once in America, they discovered their future spouse, married, and eventually settled and raised their families in and around what became Anoka County before Minnesota was even a state. As I took the bus route and looked at the land, I thought, I am here in Ireland because my dad's grandparents left Ireland in the 1840s and traveled to America. They left the familiar land for a new land, not knowing what awaited them in America. And once in America, they made a difference in their respective communities through their work on the farm, in the community, at church, and in their families. I am a descendant of their decision to go to America. I share a little Talbot history as we hear about Abraham in our second reading. God called him to leave his homeland and travel to a land he knew not, to face challenges he knew not. Abraham and Sarah were old. The last thing on their mind, I'm sure, was moving. And yet God asked. And so they packed up and they left, realizing that they would probably never return. Abraham went on this journey because he had faith in God. He trusted that God loved him and would never ask him to do anything that was not the best for him, and that God would give him all the resources he needed to succeed. And God rewarded Abraham's faith by making him the father of many descendants, as numerous as the stars in the sky and as countless as the sands on the seashore. Not physical descendants, but spiritual children in the faith. Abraham is our father in faith. We see this type of faith in God in other Old Testament figures, including Moses and David, the prophets. Because of their faith, God's covenant was remembered and celebrated, passed from generation to generation, as we heard in our first reading. We see this type of faith in people like Zechariah, Elizabeth, and John the Baptist, who trusted in God and prepared the way of the Lord. We see this type of faith in Mary, whose yes to God gave us Jesus and our salvation. We see this type of faith in the apostles, whom Jesus invited to drop everything and to follow him, which they did. And at the end of his earthly life, Jesus sent the apostles into the world with these instructions: go and make disciples of all the nations. They obeyed the Lord, and because of their faith, we are a Catholic, meaning a universal church. We see this type of faith in countless women and men of the past 2,000 years and into our own day. God has called and sent people of every time and place to announce and make present the good news of salvation. Some have been called and sent to foreign lands, some to college campuses, some to hospitals and prisons, some to religious life, some to family life, some to the single life, some for short lives, some for long lives. Like Abraham, they have responded with lives of faith, and the kingdom of God has grown. God has called and sent disciples because he wants all people to hear the best of news, that God loves us and desires that we live with him forever, that God loves us so much that he became human in the person of Jesus. He suffered, died, rose from the dead, ascended into heaven, and now intercedes for us, making it possible for us to obtain what was once impossible, heaven. God has called each one of us in the waters of baptism and infused into us the supernatural gifts of faith, hope, and charity. He then sent us to proclaim the good news, and he renews that call every day. I don't care what happened yesterday. Get up, pick up your cross, and follow me. He calls and sends us just as he called Abraham, Moses, Mary, the apostles, and many women, men and women of every age. Too often the response to the call is, I'm too young, I'm too old, I'm not the right person, I'm this, I'm that. To which the Lord responds, you're not too young and you're not too old for what I am asking. Rather, you're the perfect person for what I'm asking you, because I have created you specifically for the work that I am now entrusting to you, and I give you everything you need to succeed. Okay, Lord, I'll go. But not yet. I'm busy. How about when I graduate, when I get married, when I retire? The Lord is very clear in today's gospel, do not wait. You do not know the hour when I will call for you. Therefore, go when I ask, go where I ask. Have faith in me, and have faith in yourself, because I am acting in and through you. Trust that I'm going to give you everything that you need. The most important gift God gives us is the Mass, at which we are present for and we participate in the perfect act of faith, Jesus obeying the Father until death. From this participation of the Mass, we are fed in word and sacrament. God gives us himself so that we can better know and accomplish what he asks of us. We're conformed to the Lord in the Eucharist. We're conformed and we're united to each other, making it possible to accomplish through the church work we could never do on our own. God has already called you, and the question for today, where is God sending you? Maybe it's to a particular person who needs a word of encouragement. Maybe it's to serve in a particular ministry, to extend a word of mercy, to ask for forgiveness, to pray more regularly, to meditate on that scripture passage that's been nagging at you. Maybe it's to get married in the church, to attend the seminary or enter religious life. Maybe it's to leave home for school or work, for the military. God calls, God sends, God equips, and then we, like Abraham, are to go because God asks, to go in faith and to go without fear. During my travels through the countryside of Ireland, I thought of my great-grandparents, and I shed a few tears with my eyes to the window, tears of gratitude, thinking of them and the sacrifices they made to come to America, sacrifices that built the kingdom of God here in Minnesota and provided opportunities for generations of people like me that they would never, ever meet. So it can be for each of us and our lives of faith. By listening to the Lord's call and going where he sends us, wonderful things will happen for us and for many others, sometimes generations away. God's kingdom will grow, and pray God, future generations will shed a few tears in gratitude for our faith. But most importantly, God will be pleased. For blessed are those servants whom the master finds vigilant on his arrival. Amen, I say to you, he will gird himself, have them recline at table, and proceed to wait on them. God will bless our faith with faith's reward, communion with God, heaven. Together now we make our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. With faith in God and faith in his great love for us, we turn to him with our prayers.
That all members of the church be vigilant in doing God's will and always remain faithful disciples of Jesus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That world leaders may have a common goal for an end to violence and terror against the helpless and each other, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have been forced from their homelands by political or religious strife may find in others God's promise of care, we pray to the Lord. That God may protect those who keep watch through the night in the work of law enforcement, fire service, emergency medical service, and military service. We pray to the Lord. That each of us carry forward Jesus' saving mission with vigilance and fidelity. We pray to the Lord. For the homebound, hospitalized, and sick. May they be treated with dignity, patience, and love. We pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially Jeanette Johnson, mother of Judy Morku, Andy Rickey, Connie Mueller, and Tom Manlett. May they rejoice in seeing all they believed in and hoped for. We pray to the Lord. For all of our personal intentions, and especially for Judith Ann Longville, Eugene Noren, and St. Mary's Parish, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We see many people in our own community and in our nation affected by natural disasters. We pray for them, for their safety, and that God's people would come to their aid. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty God, you have called us in baptism, infused us with faith, hope, and charity, and sent us as your disciples to proclaim the good news. Help us to respond like Abraham, like Mary and the apostles, to do your will, simply because you ask of us. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.
You are my center, you are my life.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of a new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you've summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let's acknowledge one another with some sign or word of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. For those joining us via live stream, welcome. I invite you to make an act of spiritual communion with us, praying together. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I am spiritually into my heart. I embrace this you for already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated. Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. A couple of announcements. There's hospitality in the St. Joseph room today. We please stay for state fair themed treats. So we have popcorn, steak on a stick. Okay, we don't have steak on a stick. We have popcorn. We have popcorn. I think there's some other treats back here. So we're getting close to school. Frasati's still looking for a third grade teacher. So if anyone out there knows of someone who's looking for a job, maybe they're moving back, maybe they're just getting out of college and they haven't, they're still discovering themselves, but they're now open to teach, please contact the school. So we can have our full complement of teachers when we're ready to go. Okay, that's it. Have a great weekend, everybody. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord with your life. Thanks be to God.